This is the spectrum of FM signal. Now it has got so many sidebands, and each sideband has an amplitude which depends upon A and beta. Now, as you move away from the origin, or as NVL increases, the spectrum components are decreasing. They will decrease like this. All are not having same amplitude. Okay, so their amplitude is decreasing as N increases. Okay. Now, in the last class, we have seen that if beta is very, very small, we have only got three components. What are they? J naught beta, J1 beta, J minus 1 beta. So this is the spectrum of FM signal. And theoretically, the bandwidth is how much? Infinity. Why? Because, so what is the bandwidth? If you take only three sidebands, what is this bandwidth in the figure? FC minus 3 FM to FC plus 3 FM, that is 6 FM. So if you take three sidebands, it is 6 FM. If you take infinity sidebands, obviously bandwidth is infinity, but practically that is not desirable. Okay, practically we cannot have a infinity bandwidth. What we do is, so we don't transmit all the sidebands. We transmit only particular number of sidebands which are very, very significant. Significant means they have got 90% of the power, total power. Okay, we'll see it. Now, obviously, so yeah, as J and beta is negligible or approximately equal to zero when N is more than beta plus one. Okay, so when N is more than beta plus one, here you can see. So from the figure, if N is more than beta plus one, so J and beta is approximately zero. Okay, you can observe the above statement from the above figure. From this figure, you can observe. Okay, take beta equal to one. So beta equal to one means N should be more than two. When N is more than two, if N equal to three, so let us take here, it is zero. Near to zero, approximately zero. Okay, so this is a property of Bessel function. Okay, now what happens here? The sidebands, so they depends upon J and beta. When N is more than beta plus one, this J and beta will be almost zero, which means sidebands also very, very negligible. Okay, so that's why we say that beta plus one number of sidebands are significant sidebands. Among infinity sidebands, only beta plus one number of sidebands are significant. Okay. Now, obviously, these are the properties of spectrum. Yeah, because they contain 98% of the total power. Beta plus one number of sideband contains 98% of the total transmitted power. So that's why we restrict ourselves only to beta plus one number of sidebands. Obviously, if the sidebands are beta plus one, what is the bandwidth? 2 into beta plus one into FM. Obviously. Why? Because you can observe from this figure, if there are three sidebands, what a bandwidth? FC minus 3 FM to FC plus 3 FM, 6 FM. For three sidebands, the bandwidth is 6 FM. Obviously, for beta plus one number of sidebands, it is 2 into beta plus 1 into FM. Okay, so this is a further formula. This is the final formula of bandwidth of FM signal. Okay, so but this is for single tone. In generally, what is the bandwidth of FM signal formula? 2 into delta F plus W. Okay, so this is the bandwidth of message signal. Okay, now remember this. It is called Carson's formula. It's called Carson's formula. Correct? Now, what else we can do? Yeah, these are properties. Yes, Carson's formula. Now, if beta is large, it is approximately equal to 2 into delta F. If beta is small, it is approximately equal to 2 FM. What is the bandwidth of 2 FM? Is the bandwidth of what signal? Again, AM. Okay, so this is for wide band, it is for narrow band. Yeah, I have taken one problem. Yeah, so when j and beta equal to 0, when beta equal to 2.40, 5.5, 8.6, you must remember these values. When beta equal to 2.4, j naught beta equal to 0 for the first time. Remember this. What is the significance of j naught become 0? What happens? As I told you in the last class, this is when j naught beta becomes 0. When this becomes 0, what happens? This component will vanish, which means there is no carrier component. Okay. Now, this is a commercial radio. You must remember these values. All AM radios operate from 542 1600 kilohertz. FM stations operate from 88 to 108. At least you can open your mobile phone and you can check the FM radio. In mobiles, there is FM radio, you know. You check the stations. Okay, always they will be from 88 to 108 megahertz. So these are some typically available FM stations and corresponding frequencies. Yeah, so we have something called intermittent frequency, that is 455 for AM, 10.7 megahertz for FM. Yeah, mixing and heterodyny. Right? I explained in the last class itself, mixing means changing the center frequency of the modulated signal. Okay. So basically M of T, baseband signal, modulation is happening. It becomes M of T into C of T. Modulation means frequency translation. So this is M of F, and after modulation, this is a signal. Okay. So after modulation, what happened? Center frequency is changing from 0 to what? FC. It is baseband, it is passband. Now we have to change the center frequency of this signal. Okay. So it is nothing but frequency translation. What is the best method to have a frequency translation? Multiply with cosine term. Okay. So this is what we need. So we need to translate FC to IF. What is IF? Intermediate frequency. It's a fixed frequency. For AM it is 455 kilohertz, FM it is 10.7 megahertz. Now we have to do this translation. How to do it? Again, multiply with the cosine term. Okay. Here again, what do? We take a modulated signal, multiply with cosine term. Okay. So this is modulated signal. Correct. So this is called local oscillator. So we are multiplying with the frequency fc plus or minus f1. So you can take either plus n or minus n. So what you get here is m of t cos 2 pi f1 t. Okay. Now generally this is the output of the mixer. What happened here now? So the what is input to the mixer? This is input to the mixer with center frequency fc. Now what output of the mixer? Same signal with a different center frequency f1. F1 is nothing but IF. This should be IF. So I've written only for expression purpose, it should be IF actually. Now FC to IF. This is called mixing. But here, so we need to use some filtering also, right? We have to remove some other components. What filter will you use? Band pass filter. Correct? So right, this is same thing I told you. Yeah, so we use band pass filter to remove this frequency component. So output of the mixer you get like this. Yeah, so the problem with mixing is image frequency. What is that? Image frequency. Okay, so let me take a simple example. I will explain like this. So remember this cos term. Cos A into cos B equal to 1 by 2 cos A plus B plus cos A minus B. So AB, A into B is nothing but A plus B plus A minus B. Okay. Now, so I want to make it a simple mathematical calculation here. M of T, C of T. What is center frequency? FC. Okay. Mixing, no? Now we have a local oscillator whose frequency is FC plus IF. I'm taking only plus sign here. Is it okay? Now what will happen now? We are multiplying FC with FC plus IF. You assume this is A, cos A. This is cos B. I'm not writing cos terms. Is it okay, all of you? I'm just writing FC, FC plus A. I'm writing only frequencies, not cos terms. So let us make the calculus very simple. A into B is nothing but what? A plus B plus A minus B. What is A plus B? FC plus IF. The frequency components at the output of this multiplier is 2FC plus IF, one component. Other component is A minus B, IF. Is it okay? Now, so this can be eliminated by passing through band pass filter. You get only IF. Clear? That is a mixing. Now, suppose instead of FC, if I take 2FC plus IF. Sorry. If I take FC plus 2IF. Okay. So input to the mixer is FC plus 2F and the same local oscillator. Now this is A now. What will happen? A plus B means FC plus 2IF plus FC plus IF. What do you get? 2FC plus 3IF. In the second case, you get 2FC plus 3IF. Okay. Now A minus B. This minus this. FC plus 2F minus FC plus IF. What do you get? IF. Now what happening? This can be removed from the band pass filter. So output of the mixer is IF. Okay. So if you use the same mixer, what is happening? The mixer is same with the local oscillator frequency FC plus IF. Okay. What happened here? So FC is translated to IF. That is good. But at the same time, FC plus 2IF also translated to IF. This is called image frequency. With respect to FC. Why? Because if you take a mixer, a single mixer, if you apply FC, output is IF. If you apply FC plus 2F, then also output is IF. Okay. At the output of the mixer, we are getting IF. Okay. Now these two are called mirrors, mirror frequencies. So FC plus 2IF is a mirror frequency of FC. Why? Because if you apply FC or FC plus 2F, output of the mixer is same. Correct? So that is a problem. Now that is a problem of mixer, that is image frequency. Okay. So I have done, one more thing here I want to mention. So here I have taken local oscillator frequency is FC plus IF. There are two possibilities. As I mentioned in the previous slide, either you can take FC plus IF or FC minus IF. Okay. But so we prefer this over this. So this should be local oscillator frequency. So if it is FC plus IF, it is called super. Remember this. If the local oscillator frequency is FC plus IF, we'll call this super. Okay. Now you can also take FC minus IF, but we don't take this with a specific reason. Okay. Remember this. Now from now onwards, I will use only FC plus IF as a local oscillator frequency, not plus or minus. I don't write plus or minus, only plus. Okay. Now that is the image frequency. Now, so the problem of mixer is having image frequency. Yeah. So I explained this here. Yes. So FC is translated to F1 or IF. FC plus 2F1 is also translated to F1. Okay. That is a problem. So image frequency for FC is FC plus 2IF. Okay, let us take an example. So what they're saying? Yeah, this example. Okay, consider AM's radio transmission for with FC equal to 600 Hz, kilohertz. IF equal to 455 kilohertz. Then mixing frequency is this much. Find the image frequency. What image frequency would be? If FC equal to 600 kilohertz, what is the local oscillator frequency? FC plus IF. That means for FC, for AM, this is AM. AM, what is IF? 455, which means 600 plus 455, that is 1045 kilohertz. This is the local oscillator. Okay. Now, so what is the, so what happens now? 600 will be translated to 455 IF. Okay. Now what image frequency now? So image frequency is FC plus 2 times IF. That is 600 plus 2 into IF means 455. What is that now? So that is 600 plus 900. Am I right? How much? 600 plus 900? Sorry, 910. No, this is 910. Okay, so that is 1510. Now, what happened here? So to the mixer, if you apply 600, it will be translated to 455. If you apply 1510 also, it will be translated to same 455 kilohertz. Okay, now 1510 is image frequency for what's it, what for 600. Okay, they're called image stations. What they're called now? Image station. 600, 1510 are called image stations. So what is the difference between these two? How much is the difference between image two image stations? 1510 minus 600. That is 910. Am I right? Is it right? Okay, actually the difference is 2 times IF. So the difference between two image stations is 2 times IF. Is it okay? Now what is the problem with these mixers and image frequency? Okay, so let us briefly discuss now. Okay, any doubts you can ask me now. If you don't have any doubts, let us proceed then. Right, now this is what the, yeah, now so this is the super heterodyne receiver. Okay, actually this is the receiver. Receiver means what? AM receiver or FM receiver. This is the receiver. This is called, we call radio, no? Actually this is a receiver. This is AM or FM, both. It has got both FM and AM. You can clearly see this. What is the FM range? 88 to 108 megahertz. What is the AM range? 53 to 170. So here they have written into 10 kilohertz. Okay, you just observe this. Now, this is a receiver. Okay. Now we'll say this is a super heterodyne receiver. What is the name of this receiver? Super heterodyne. Why it is called so? Why it is called super? Because this local oscillator frequency is fc plus if. I told you just now. If it is fc plus if, we call super. Heterodyne. Why it is called heterodyne? Because it has got a mixer. Mixing or heterodyne. I told you, no? So that's what it's called, super heterodyne receiver. Okay. Now, here. Right. Now, so here, this receiver, it contains all these blacks. Okay. So before that, let us understand this. This is a radio. Okay. So you can choose AM or FM. That is one thing. And here it has got antenna. Here this antenna, you can see very clearly. You might have seen this kind of radio solid, right? It is called telescopic antenna. Anyway. So here in the atmosphere, all the stations will be present. Station one, station two, okay, are you getting what I'm saying? All stations are present in the atmosphere. Okay. But we can only listen one station at a time. That is obvious, right? We cannot listen two stations at a time. Okay. That's why we need a tuning. It is called tuning. What is tuning? Selecting the particular station. Okay, suppose it is tuned to, let us take 100 megahertz. So let us take 100 megahertz belongs to station one, for example. Which means this receiver will only allow first station to enter because it is tuned to that frequency. It will reject remaining stations. We need an isolation. Okay. So by tuning, we'll select only particular station at a time. Obviously, we are rejecting other stations. Correct or not? Because at a time, a receiver can receive only one station. So next time, I may change the tuning to, let us take, it is not 100, no, it is 90. Okay, no problem. So let us take somewhere here. I change the tuning to somewhere around 104 megahertz. So what happened now? Other station will be selected. Let us take this is 104. Okay, like this, by tuning, we'll select only one station. You will reject the other stations. Obviously, that is a true, right? In FM also, you have to enter the frequency. Open FM in your mobile. You have to enter the frequency, right? Yeah, there are some auto tunings are there, but typically we have to enter the frequency. Okay. Now, so that is nothing but selecting. You have to select a particular station or desired station. So if you want to listen to station S4, choose that particular frequency or tune to that particular frequency. Okay, that is one thing. How it can be done? Obviously, selecting one frequency, rejecting other frequencies, nothing but filtering. Okay, so this is a receiver. First and foremost thing is filtering. This antenna, it has got all signals, all stations. Okay, here we have every station present here. All are present. But you have to select only one station. So that is nothing but RF filter, amplifier. Both are there. So we call RF section. This is called as RF section. It's a bandpass filter. RF section is a bandpass filter which selects one station at a time. Okay. Now, what should be the frequency of this filter? FC. Filter frequency should be FC. Tuning should be there, no? This is the tuning. We are tuning to FC. Okay. Why FC? FC is the carrier frequency. Okay. Now, there is an amplifier. So, if there are any attenuations, it will amplify. Now, we are having mixer. Okay. What happens now here? So, this is called these two are tuned simultaneously using a single knob. Okay, this RF section and this local oscillator are tuned simultaneously using a single common knob. Okay, so if this is tuned to FC, this will be tuned to FC plus IF. Am I okay? Here, what is the variable? Only FC, not IF. IF is fixed. If it is AM receiver, it will be FC plus 455 kilohertz. Okay, FC is changing. So if you tune to another station, FC changes, but they are tuned parallelly or simultaneously using a common knob. Okay, so you understand this. Now here, what happened here? Input to the mixer is FC with a low class of frequency FC plus IF. So what is output of the mixer would be? Obviously, how much? IF. Now we have a section here. IF filter, IF amplifier. So this is called IF section. What is called IF section? What is this filter? We need filtering each and every stage because we have to remove some other components which are not required to us. So this is IF section. Now this is a demodulator. And this is a audio amplifier, power amplifier. This is a speaker. Okay. Now what happens here? Now this is the okay. Before that, so demodulator is a part of the receiver. Okay. So receiver does not only contain demodulator, it contains some other things also. Okay. So that's why receiver is not same as demodulator. We call receiver, that is okay, but so this demodulator is a part of the receiver. We have so many components other than demodulator in this receiver, like filters, amplifiers, mixers, power amplifiers, speakers, etc. Okay, so this receiver contains all those components. Okay, this is called super heterodyne receiver. Here, this is the, if this is the envelope detector, if that is the envelope detector, it is called AM receiver. If it is something else, it is called FM receiver. Okay, now, so now this is called front end of the receiver, this entire portion before demodulator is called front end of the receiver. Okay, so these are the blocks of receiver. It is called super heterodyne receiver. Super because it is using local oscillator frequencies FC plus IF. Okay. And heterodyning means it is called mixer. So commonly called super heterodyne receiver. Okay, right. Now, so yeah, common knob. Yeah. So image frequency has to be eliminated by RF pre-filter before mixing. Yeah. So the main function of this RF section is to remove the image frequency. Why? Why? What happened now? If image frequency is there, what will happen? What happens? Suppose to the mixer, we have two inputs. Just now I told you, let me go to the last stage. Yeah. Now here, you take, just wait. Now, so this is the mixer which is present in the receiver. What happens? If you are tuning to 600, what may happen? 15-10 also may come. Both stations may overlap. Okay, so if the filtering is not proper, what may happen? Yeah, in this receiver, what may happen? So actually, you are tuning to 600 kilohertz. Okay, so your filter should select only 600 kilohertz. Okay, but you assume that if it is not good, okay, what may happen? 1510 may also enter. Now, if both are present at the input of the mixer, what may happen? They will overlap at the output. Why? Because two different stations are overlapping. Okay, so this is nothing but overlapping because two different stations are translated to same frequency. You assume this is a station station one. It is station 10. And assume that. Okay, which means you will listen two stations at a time. You will get audio from two stations at a time. Obviously, that is the overlapping. Okay, you get audio from 600 hertz as well as from 1510 hertz. Both are mixing at the output of the mixer. Two different stations are mixing, so they are called image stations. How to avoid that? This filtering should be proper. So if this filter does not allow, if this RF section does not allow this 1510, we don't have any problem. If it is rejected by RF section, no problem. So the purpose of this RF filter is to reject the image frequency. It must reject image frequency. Okay. So if it doesn't remove the image frequency comes into the mixer. After mixer, it will combine with the some other station. Okay, so that is a problem. Correct? Now, so now what is the advantage of mixing? If there is no mixer, what will happen? Is there any problem? So if there is no mixer, what is the problem? Can't you work without mixer? What happens is, suppose if there is no mixer, it is not present, remove this. What will happen? Okay, nothing will happen, no problem. So FC, this filter will select only one channel or one station. So what happens now? That will be demodulated directly given to the speaker. What's the problem? No problem. But the problem is here. So what happens is, suppose each and every station has got its own unique frequency. As I mentioned in the last classes, so if you go back to the some of the standard FM radio stations or AM radio stations, now each and every radio station has got its own unique frequency, isn't it? Radio City 91.1 megahertz, Big FM 92.7, Red FM 93.5, Radio Mirchi, AR Nizamabad, so on so on. So what happens here is, suppose you are tuning to Nizamabad, NZB. We want to listen to the Nizamabad station. Obviously, you have to reject other stations, all other stations. Except Nizamabad, everything should be rejected. What is the frequency of Nizamabad? 103.2. Okay, 103.2. So our filter is tuned to 103.2 kilohertz. Sorry, megahertz. So what happens now? So this will be demodulated and given to the radio amplifier. Okay, no problem. That is quite okay. Now, next time I want to listen to Radio City, which is operating at 91.1 megahertz. Okay, next time I want to listen to Radio City 91.1 megahertz. So what happens now? So input is 91.1 megahertz. Obviously we have to demodulate, we have to give to the amplifier. Okay, now here what happened here? The frequency of operation is changing. If you change the radio station, the frequency of operation changes. Then what happens? Each and every time you have to change the components here. Why? Because suppose if it is a AM radio, AM radio, what is the best demodulator for AM? What is that? Envelope detector. Let us take it is AM radio. AM radio, what is the demodulator? Envelope detector. Now this envelope detector contains what elements? Resistor, capacitor. This capacitor is a frequency sensitive element. What are capacitance? 1 by j omega c. What is omega? Angular frequency. Not only that, so what is the best, what should be the time constant for the best operation of this ED? It should be between 1 by fc and 1 by fm, which means if you change fc, you have to change rc values each and every time. Fc is not fixed, no? Okay, so suppose you are tuning to Nizamabad, what is fc? 103.2. now fc changes, these values will change, fm won't change. This is a message signal frequency. Now if you tune to some other stations, fc changes. So each and every time you have to change the devices or elements in the demodulator. Not only that, all these filters, amplifiers are frequency sensitive elements because they may contain resistors, inductors, some other components which are frequency sensitive elements. Okay, so each and every time you change the station, you have to change the frequency of operation. That will affect the components which are present inside the filters, amplifiers, demodulators. Okay, but if you fix the frequency, they will give better operation. They will long last. Don't you think so? Okay, that's why what we do is we use a mixer. If you use a mixer, so what is mixing? Yeah, converting FC to IF. IF is fixed. FC can vary, no problem. But IF is fixed. Now here, what happens here is, if you use a mixer, whether you are listening to Nizamabad stations or Red FM or whatever it is, doesn't matter. Output of the mixer is always constant frequency, IF, which is fixed. If it is AM, it is 455 kilohertz. FM 10.7 megahertz. You are tuning. You may tune to any station that you wish. You are tuning to any station, doesn't matter. But after mixing, that will be always converted to IF, which is fixed. Now what happens? All these devices will work at fixed frequency IF. No need to change the components, whether inductor, capacitor, resistor, whatever it is. They will be operating at fixed frequency. Okay, they are factory manufactured. So they come with manufacturing by assuming that they will operate at IF frequency. If it's AM radio, they are manufactured by assuming that they will operate at 455 kilohertz. For FM radio, they will manufacture those components by assuming that they will operate at 10.7. This is a universal truth. I mean, it is true everywhere. It doesn't change from region to region. Okay, it is fixed. So all these components are now will be operating at fixed frequency, which improves its performance. And not only that, we don't have to change elements regularly. It is not possible. How can you change the elements, right? So suppose I want to listen to Nizamabad. I have to use this capacitor, this resistor, this inductor. So if I change the stations, you have to change the elements. How it is possible? It is not possible, no? That's why we are using the mixing. Mixer will make sure that all the remaining components will be operating at fixed frequency, which is very desirable for any kind of operation. If we take a filter, amplifier, demodulator, it is better to have a fixed frequency of operation. Always it is good. Okay. Now, but the problem with the mixer is image frequency. How to avoid that? By properly designing this RF section. You design RF filter very properly so that it will not allow image frequency. Okay. Now, you may ask a question. Suppose in this example, 600, 1510. Suppose we both are present. Okay, let me tell you like this. In the mixer, it is 600. Okay, 600 is present at the input of the mixer. Now it is 1045. Now what's the output? 455. Okay. Suppose if 610 is also present, 610, 600 as well as 610, both are input to the mixer. What will happen now? What about 610? What happened? 610 is present. What will happen? 610 plus 1045. 610 minus 1045. What is this? 610 plus 1045. How much is this? 610 plus 1045. You calculate this and tell me. 1045 plus 610. It is, this is 1655. This is 1045 minus 610, 435. Is it okay? So if 600 and 610, if both are present, 600 will be translated to 455. What about 610? 435. Now, it is not image frequency. We don't have any problem. Because except 455, remaining frequency will be rejected by the filter. Okay. Now, this is very, very important. 610 is not a problem. Obviously, 620 is also not a problem. We don't have any problem with 610, 620, 630. Because they are not translating into 455, but only 1510. This is only translating into 455. That's why we have problem with 1510, not with 610. Okay, that's what is called image frequency. You understand this very, very carefully. Is it okay? Right. Now, don't think that each and everything is the image frequency. No. Image frequency means FC plus 2 times IF. If FC is 600, 600 plus 910, this is image frequency, because now these both are translating into same fixed frequency. That is IF. But 610, no. We don't have any problem with 610. Now, here, so generally, image frequency and normal frequency. What is the difference? 600 is a original frequency. Its image frequency is 1510. So the difference is 910 kilohertz or megahertz. So there is a huge difference. So we don't have any problem with this. It can be rejected by RF section. Why I'm saying so? Let me go with this. So this RF section is a band pass filter, no? Right? So we have band pass filter. So it is tuned to FC. Okay. Now, so no problem, it will allow this FC frequency, but this band pass filter should not allow FC plus 2 times IF, this frequency somewhere here. So this should be rejected by band pass filter. It will happen eventually. Why? Because the gap is how much? 910 kilohertz. Obviously, any filter will not allow a gap of 910 kilohertz. Suppose if it is FC, it may allow a FC plus 20, FC minus 20. Okay, so suppose if the filter is designed for FC, obviously FC plus 2F, which has got difference of 910, will not pass to the filter. Generally, it won't happen. Okay, so but if it all happens, it is a problem. Right. So now doubts. Okay. You can ask me in doubts if you want. Okay, any doubts? You can ask me now. So after doubt section, we'll stop now. Okay. Right, somebody asked a question. What is that? Who is this? Mohan. Sorry, I didn't see it. Any doubts? You can ask me now. It is very, very important. Anyone? You can type the question at least. Hello. Okay, so if you don't have any doubts, we'll proceed. So that is about receiver. So I briefly tell you multiplexing. Now you take an example of road. Okay, so this is a road, in between we have a divider. Okay, so by dividing the road, we can allow vehicles to pass through simultaneously without colliding with each other. What will happen? So this side vehicles move like this, this side vehicle moves like this. Okay, so in between we have a divider. We are dividing the road into two parts so that vehicles move simultaneously without accidents. Correct, this is the thing we know already. If we divide them, obviously they won't collide with each other, but they will travel simultaneously. Anytime we can travel simultaneously without colliding with each other, obviously that is true. Now we employ same thing in case of multiplexing. What is multiplexing basically? Now we talk in terms of communication. What is that? You take a channel, something like this. Okay, so in the channel, through the channel, I want to transmit multiple signals simultaneously. I want to transmit multiple signals simultaneously. So I am transmitting multiple signals simultaneously over the same channel. Now this is a channel. This is a channel. Through the channel, I am transmitting signal 1, signal 2, signal 3, and signal 4 simultaneously without overlapping. That is called multiplexing. Transmitting more number of signal through same channel without overlapping with each other. How it is possible? That is the question. Okay, how it is possible? By dividing the channel, it is possible. How I divide? I'll say that, so this is the slot for first signal. This is the slot allocated to the first signal, which means it has to travel through that path only. Now I'll allocate one more path to the second signal. It has to travel through that path only, third and fourth. Now what I've done is I've divided the entire channel into some parts and I've allocated to each and every signal, just like we have done a divider. We are divided into two parts, so one for moving in the upper direction, one for moving in the downward direction. So here, what I have done, we have divided into two parts. One is to move in this direction, another is to move in this direction, so that they won't collide. In the same way, here we don't have a collision problem, but there is a problem overlapping. So we allocate a path to each and every signal, dedicated path. Okay, we say that this is belongs to you, this path belongs to you, this path belongs to you, so and so, so that they won't overlap with each other. That is called multiplexing. Dividing the channel is called multiplexing. Okay, so multiplexing basically means transmitting more number of signals through the channel simultaneously by dividing the channel. Okay, now here comes the logic. How to divide a channel? it can be divided into so many types. We can divide in bandwidth, we can divide in time, we can divide in wavelength also. Okay, now what happens here is we'll discuss multiplexing. And this is very, very important. Multiplexing requires that multiple signals be kept apart so that they don't overlap. So they should be kept apart. So I have maintained some gap between them. They should have a gap between, in between. Otherwise, they will overlap. Okay. This is a gap. Now, so we'll study about this multiplexing in the next class. Okay. Right. So if you have any doubts, you can ask me. Otherwise, we'll stop. I'll wait for 5 minutes. Okay, right. So we stop now. Thank you.